Doesn't it feel like Christmas? 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 Welcome to Vlogmas day 4. You guys haven't seen me in a couple days. It is, let's see, 22 days until Christmas. I've already been missing for days 2, 3, 4, you know. I'm sorry, but I'm just going to try to knock out Vlogmas. Like, I'm not going to promise y'all a video every day, but I'm going to get y'all a couple more videos in, more than usual. So today what we're doing is I'm about to measure this room real quick. That's what I meant to get while I was downstairs. I'm gonna measure this room because one of my Christmas gifts from Ricky is gonna be my closet. So I need to re-measure the room because I had measured it, but I didn't include the windows and the door entries because I was like, I'll just measure the walls and I'm only putting stuff on the wall. So that's the only measurements I need, right? Wrong, because when they put it in the system, they take account to how big the room is. So when I don't add the walls, when I don't add the windows or the, my phone ring. When I don't add the windows or the doors, it makes the room a lot more smaller. So it looks like a lot can't fit in there. So yes, I'm about to go measure that. I need to find a measuring tape and then put those measurements in my little book, and then we're gonna go to IKEA. So when we first moved in, I got some quotes from a couple different closet designers, and y'all, the price was giving, I'ma live in this closet. That's what the price was giving. Like, I can make a whole nother room into my house, add on, that's what it was giving. It was costing too much. And I got a couple different quotes, so they were all about the same. So, we're not doing that. I'm not spending that much money. Maybe in my next house, my dream home that I'm gonna live in forever, I'll do it. But then this is only my first home, so I don't want to do all that and then leave it for the next person because, child, too much money. I don't give away free money. So, we're gonna go with the IKEA Pax closet. And it's only a fraction of the price. I'm not saying it's cheap or anything, because IKEA is still some coins, honey. But it's not as much as, it's not expensive as the ones I was getting quoted. Because I was getting quote 10, 15K for a closet, y'all. This room is already looking a mess, but I'm using a room upstairs for my closet. The one that's connected halfway to the bathroom, to the hallway bathroom. That's the one I'm using. So let me try to prop you guys up. And I chose this room because it does have the side with the half bath, like right here. I have this bath, the sink and stuff, so I could do my makeup right here if I wanted to. And then it has another closet in here. And I've been putting my purses and stuff in here. And so this is another closet. And then out here is another closet that's actually within the room. So I got a lot of space to work with in this room, so it's ideal. So that's the one I'm gonna go with. So we got our measurements. So now it's time to get dressed and go to IKEA. All right, y'all, I'm in my husband's car. The back seats do go down, so we cooking with grace. Now, first we gotta go get us a little drink from Starbucks. Yeah, so I was gonna make me a drink and I was like, why when I can buy one? Because usually when you make drinks at home, it's because you don't feel like going anywhere to get one. But and I don't have my stand in this car for this camera, so I apologize in advance. Let me close the garage. I don't like his car because you can't see shit. Wrong one. Alright. Okay, it's going down. I don't like my husband's car at first. One is so fucking loud. I don't know why he likes this loud ass shit. Two, I don't like the dark windows. Granted, it's not as dark as his other car. His old car.
Turn right.
You couldn't hear nothing. You couldn't see nothing.
Turn left.
Nothing.
Then turn right onto Prairie Ridge Boulevard.
All right, girl. I really don't need you. I know. I get the gist of where I'm going. Yeah, I know I live in a new neighborhood. And I'm sorry if you can't hear me because it's loud ass car. But I live in a new neighborhood. So we live in the country. It's right off the highway. So they really had to do some changes as far as getting in and out of this neighborhood, because now that it's so many people that live over here, it's really hard to get in and out because it's a highway and those folks are going 70-80 miles per hour on the highway, and you gotta try to get out of there, out of our neighborhood onto the highway going that fast. Like, it's almost impossible. And they have like a little median you shoot through to try to get across, but there was like so many accidents, because it was really dangerous. They really should have put a light there, but anyway, they did put the light there. They finally put like a roundabout thingy where you go across and you do a, like a U-turn, and it's kind of, it flows with the traffic now, you know. But I don't like going out that way because I don't want to have to go to the right to make a U-turn to go back up left. So I go out behind the neighborhood. And there's another like shoot across, and I'm good at shooting across, child. I ain't scared driving, but some other people ain't. So I just keep going this way. The thing is these back roads that I be taking to not get on the main highway, they raggedy as fuck. Like, these are some country ass roads. Granted, it's not, at least it's not gravel. It's a little concrete with a lot of rocks, but they raggedy, y'all. Raggedy. Probably not good for the car. But oh well, I'd rather go this way than down the main street because I don't like all that turning around stuff. But yeah, let's go get some Starbeezy. I don't even know what I want to get. I think I'm going to get some matcha. I haven't had matcha in a while. So I think I'm going to get a matcha. Lately, I've been getting my sugar cookie latte. My sugar cookie latte hit, baby. Iced. Okay. Caramel drizzle. Sweet foam. Chef's kiss. Okay, y'all, this when I shoot across. Baby, you get. Baby, you get. Damn, it's actually a lot of cars out for it to be Sunday. Go after this one, and I'm gonna hit it. So hold on, y'all. You gotta hit it. That's one reason I do like his car, because you can hit it in this bitch. My car looks slow. I won't tell him that though. I would never tell my husband that. I'ma tell him I can race it till I die, okay? Doesn't it feel like Christmas? Doesn't it feel like Christmas? What y'all know about that Destiny Child Christmas, honey? Used to bump. But this line is long. My baby. Y'all, do I want to get something to eat too? Kinda, yeah. I'm kinda hungry. But I don't know how hungry I am. I'm hungry. I mean, it's 12 o'clock noon and I haven't ate today yet. But Starbucks just be taxing, so I don't know if I want to get something from here. You know what I can do? I can get something to eat at IKEA. Them meatballs be hitting. But I really don't feel like eating that. That's the problem. I got $8 on my Starbucks card, y'all. Y'all think my drink gonna be more than $8? Probably so. My drink be high as hell. My friend work at Starbucks and she be like, girl, what you be getting to get an $8 drink? And I be like, it be superior. My drinks be hitting, boy. I think I'm gonna get a matcha today with my little twist on it. My drink be good as fuck, okay? Ain't nobody tell me otherwise.
Thank you for choosing Starbucks. What can I get started for you today?
Yes, can I get a grande iced matcha latte with oat milk, 2 pumps of vanilla, add sweet cream with strawberry puree blended into the sweet cream. And can you put in a venti cup?
Just 1 second.
That's how you order, baby.
Hi, I had the grande ice matcha with 2 pumps of vanilla and strawberry cream in the foam. It's gonna be $7.58. Would you like a receipt?
No, thank you.
Would you like a straw?
Oh, no, thank you.
Have a good day.
Thank you. So good. I just took 20 minutes of my damn life. Definitely went the wrong way. Man, that's so good, y'all. Let me tell y'all a funny story. Or not so funny story. Ooh, so well. So I made a little YouTube short to post to show y'all my favorite Starbucks drink the other day. Y'all know what I did? I recorded me going to Starbucks, then making my drink, the whole little Starbucksy vibe. And then I did exactly what I'm doing now. I killed the drink. And I forgot to show y'all the drink after I got the drink. I was so mad at myself, y'all. But the drinks be so good. That's how much I love Starbucks. Like, I've been a Starbucks girl before being a Starbucks girl was a thing, okay? I used to buy Starbucks all the time. Like, in high school. Hit my head and everything. All right, y'all. We made it. Let's try this again. Let's go. IKEA will really have you buying stuff you don't need, like This is kind of cute, right? It's a picture. I've been looking for a good picture. And it got a lid. We're going to get this. Because I want to be, like, when I want to make an alcoholic punch, I don't want a big picture.
I know, right?
Just a nice looking one. And that's a nice looking one. Let me show y'all. Aren't these some cute ones? They have like ornaments in it. This would be a good container for ornaments. But it's $24.99. That's a bit much. That's a bit much for me. This is the desk, y'all. Now I found the one. See, it has like that glass up top so you can clean it. And a drawer. This one is $169. Kind of like that one. And this one is cute too. It's much higher though, $250. I don't know about that, but that's a good compartment. And I like this right here. This will be good to do my makeup in, huh, y'all? That one? Oh, found the closets. These are smaller. See, I think I need something small like this, though. Like, I don't need too much. I don't know. We'll see. We shall see. I think I'll do that and then I'll add it into the, that way I can like actually move the, I can actually move the table when it's not in the middle. All right. We have found the pack system. So let's go. Do like an open, y'all know how I have the closet inside the closet, so I think I'm gonna do the open shelving, do the open shelving there, and then build the closet on the outside. Let's see. Y'all, Mira is secured. So I got my closets. Woo! So excited. So the total for my closet is only going to cost $2,800. That's a good deal, child. Got this little pitcher, these little hot things for the kitchen. So the mirror I got, there was one that was bigger, that was about 10 inches taller. It was huge, taller than me, but it was also wider. So I don't know if it was gonna fit right there, especially since there's a door. So I just got this one to play it safe. So let's unbox it, y'all. where I wanted to go. Up there. I thought it came with screws to mount it. I guess not. It's 33 pounds, y'all. 33. I really need to get that sideboard for that area, because when I do take a picture, I can see all these behind me and it looks a mess, boxes after boxes. So yeah, now I can take you a full length picture, honey. And I'm real excited about this closet, y'all. Y'all just don't know. I can't wait till my, let me show y'all the garage while we're out here. The garage with all my stuff. Y'all, it's really sad.
Garage door.
I'm really ashamed I want to show y'all, but I'm going to show y'all. Here's the garage. Y'all, all of those bins are my clothes. All of that crap over there is mine. So, yeah. My closet gets done. I can clean this out. But y'all, I got some clothes and shoes and stuff. Like, shop. First of all, I'm a shopaholic, so I shop all the time. Next, I like clothes, shoes, purses. Like, it's just me. That's just who I am. So, yeah. So when that closet gets done, she gonna be cute or whatever. And then I did ask them about the TaskRabbit to put the closet together, and that is too expensive. They charge like, the TaskRabbit charges like $88 per unit. And I got like 7 units. So it's like $600, $700. Yeah, and I think that's too much. So I guess Ricky gonna have to suck it up. I'm gonna have to suck it up, however you want to put it. And he gonna have to build that in one day and not play with me, because he likes to play when it comes to time to build stuff and do it on his own time. And I'm not feeling that, okay? Like, I want my shit done when I want it done. Do you hear me? Not take 3-4 weeks to put stuff. No, baby, do my closet in one day. That's why I really wanted to hire somebody. So if he want to waste $600-$700 and pay somebody to put it together, then fine, be my guest. But don't let that be my money, because you can put it together. You just don't want to put together. So that's what I'm going to tell him. That's what I'm going to tell him anyway. I mean, he can put it together, y'all. He really can. That IKEA closet, everybody says, is so easy to do. But it's time consuming, and the, like, there's no really real instructions when you put IKEA stuff together. It'd be like pictures. But all right, my husband's out with his friends, and I am a little jealous because I wanted some food from that side of town, from this place called Nukes, because it's so good and I was craving it last night. I wanted Nukes so bad. So I told him before he comes home today to go buy Nukes on that side of town and bring me some, because I don't want to drive an hour. I mean, he's already going to be there. And now he won't hurry up and come home, because he's at Main Event. And I don't want to rush him home, but I want that food. Because I can care less if he's here tonight. Because, I mean, I can go watch my shows and be very content. It's just the fact that I want that food. That's really all it's about. What else? I might make me a little drink, holiday drink. Or maybe I'll wait. I really don't need to be drinking. Y'all want to open some Amazon packages? Yes, let's do that. Let's open some Amazon packages. Let me go get them. These are my little tree skirt, because I don't have a tree skirt. And then one is a carpet from outside. My little background carpet to put my name. Ew, I think I'm missing. This looks cheap. So this houndstooth, this was my skirt. I mean, it don't look bad on camera, but the material, I'm not really. Let me see. I'm not a fan of this material. It's not cute. Like, the print is cute, houndstooth, but the material is So I'm gonna take this back. And I already saw one at, was it Michael's? That was houndstooth, and it was like basically the same price. So I'm gonna go back and get that one because I don't like this one. Oh well. This is the rug. I was gonna put this rug down first and then put my like Grinch one because it's much smaller. So kind of layer it in the front on the porch. It's like a black and white stripe. So you kind of like keep my little, you know, decor theme going. I mean, they put this in the smallest bag they could find. Let's see what this is looking like. Okay, this one's cute. It's just a stripe. And I'm gonna put the Grinch over it. So we can go outside and do that, y'all. I think this other one is my Grinch hand. I told y'all, remember my wreath from day one of Vlogmas I made? I bought a Grinch hand to like stick out. I thought it was the cutest thing ever. Oh, and I forgot about this skincare stuff for my husband. I don't know how I'm gonna put it up there, but isn't that cute? I wanna put like a little ball right there and put that in there. So let's go to the front patio and put this all down and see how curt it is. I gotta change. So I'm gonna get this Grinchmas welcome mat, and then I'm gonna take the Richardson one. I don't know where I'm gonna put the Richardson one. Maybe my back patio. Down. Maybe I'll turn it the other way. Yeah, that looks better. How cute! And I had a big, I got a big ornament made at Michael's. Well, y'all know my last name is so long, Richardson. So I usually just go with. I usually just shorten my last name and just do Rich anyway, because Richardson is so dang long, too many letters. And so when I tried to get the ornament made, they was like, yeah, that's too many letters, can't do that many letters. So I'm gonna put this in the back. So I just put the Rich on the ornament. So I'm gonna show y'all that too. This tree skirt is going back. Because it's ugly in person. I mean, on camera, it kind of looks cute, but it's really ugly in person. And we ain't doing that. So let me go get the ornament. Here it is. It says the Rich. I wanted to say Richardson family, but too many letters, so. The Rich. So what, I was gonna put some lights in this and just put it on the front porch. Isn't that the cutest? And I got this at Michael's. So if you guys wanna go to Michael's, they were 40% off. I think it was like maybe $20. If it was $20, it might not even been $20. And it took about a week for them to make, but I thought it was the cutest. So I'm gonna put some lights and put it on the front porch. It's cute. Our backyard, and I was just playing with it to see how it is. I didn't anchor them down right. And my husband came home, he was like, you always act like you can't wait for me. And I can't because I be trying to do everything myself. So I didn't anchor them down. Anyway, I went in the house, forgot about them. Didn't really think about them. It was like 10:30, 11 at night, and my husband jumps up and runs outside. And I'm like, what is he doing? And he finally comes back in. I was like, what happened? What's going on? He was like, you didn't anchor down those inflatables, and they were rolling all the way down the street. I bust out the laugh, and I was like, how do you know it was down the street? Like, how did you know to go outside and look? He said, because I looked outside, and the wind was blowing so hard, and I could hear it. And all I thought about was those inflatables you didn't anchor down after I told you.
Ah! Tickle. Tickle. So he racing down the street trying to catch our inflatables.
Yeah, he was so pissed at me. He was mad at me. And he threw them in the garage. So I'm going to pick another day and put my inflatables outside, and I'm going to actually anchor them. Whoops. I didn't know they was going to blow away. They were all plugged up. Oh, well. So that was funny. Like, I got a good laugh out of that. He did. He wasn't happy, but yeah. All right, y'all. So I watched Jaleesa Vaughn, if y'all know her on YouTube, her Christmas decorations she showed us, and they were so cute. So she does white, silver, and gold, and she does it every year the same, she says, and it matches everything, and it makes sense. Why didn't I think of that? So she had the prettiest garland going down her stair. Case, and I want to do the same thing. So I really should have went by Walmart, because I was looking for some pool noodles, because I saw this little hack on TikTok to just decorate the pool noodle, and then you put it on top of your stair railing, and then when it's time to take it down, you just take it off. Genius. So I was gonna do that. So I was gonna go look for some pool noodles, but I forgot, and now I'm at the house and I don't want to go nowhere. But I really want to do that down my staircase, because hers, it's so pretty. And I did contact, she lives in Dallas too. I contacted the people that did hers. Y'all know how much they charge. They told me $4,000, y'all. $4,000 to decorate my tree and my stair. And that's when I provided everything. $4,000. And if they provided anything or they bought anything, they would invoice me the amount of whatever they bought. So needless to say, they won't be doing mine, but they did a good job on hers. Like, it's really pretty. I loved it. And I was like, okay, I would love to do that to mine. Like, it would be so pretty. It looks so good, but I'm not paying $4,000. I'm not at that stature yet. Like, I ain't rolling the dough like that. Like, I'm not spending $4,000 for them to decorate a tree and that. Like, get somebody else to do it. Get somebody else to do it, because it's not going to be me. Actually, it is going to be me. I'm going to be doing it, not them. But yeah, so I do plan on doing that. So we maybe tomorrow, I don't know, one of these videos, we probably going to go get the pool noodles before Vlogmas is up. And we're going to try to do that staircase thing, because when I say it was gorgeous, go look at her video, y'all. Jaleesa Vaughn. She's in Dallas too. And her Christmas decorations are chef's kiss. But we're gonna probably do better next year. This year, I feel like I'm so overwhelmed, because not only am I decorating my house, I'm trying to decorate for a holiday, and I don't even have everything for my house yet. So I feel like it was just too much for me. And then I overloaded, and now I just don't want to do nothing. So next year, we'll do better next year. So maybe I'll do that next year, but I think I want to do it this time, because I think that'll just make the stairs pop, and then I can take some cute pictures, holiday pictures by my stairs, because it'll be cute. So yeah, anyway, I'm rambling. I'm not finna do nothing, finna watch some TV, so I'll probably catch up with you guys later. Toodles. Y'all, why my husband just come home and say, I like this mirror? I said, I know, I want you to mount it right here. He gonna say some, but it's not going right there. That's my door right there. I gotta open it. Like, he can't open the other door. Anyways, I got my food. I'm finna eat. I got my nukes. So I'm in this vlog here. Thanks you guys for tuning in. If you're not already subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the bell notification so you don't miss a video. See you guys later.